Leia, no.
Good morning, beautiful. Come on, can you at least show me how you look in that dress?
I don't really have time to put on a fashion show.
Are you still mad with me that I'm not coming with you?
Please do. I want you to meet my mom.
You know I have to go back to Moscow.
Yeah, your students are more important than me.
I'll come back in 1 month for the conference and then we'll visit your mom.
Promise?
I promise. And what about your promise? You're moving to Moscow with me. No more secret missions. No more leaving in the middle of the night.
No more nightmares. You know I will. If I go on like this, there won't be anything left of me. I'll put in my papers as soon as I get back.
And what about your brother?
He'll survive. You know what I mean. I have to take a shower.
Sorry, I'm in a hurry. My mom's waiting.
Gwen, stop it! I'm moving it right now!
How many times I told you do not park in this place and you're not listening? It's the ticket for you. You've got 14 days to make a payment, please.
You know me, I'll pay it.
And never come back here again. Thank you very much, Ida.
Time.
thought you were coming yesterday. I had to take care of a couple of things before. But now I'm here. I wasn't trying to complain to you. I was just worried you wouldn't show up. I'll be finished in 15 minutes. Do you need any help? Don't worry, I'm fine. Okay. Leah. Yeah, Mom? Do you really think Sydney did the right thing? Floyd is a very attractive man, but Leah, he's a soldier. A soldier in the Special Forces. Mom. Leah. She will be alone a lot. And I know how that feels. What else should she do? She's pregnant after all. Maybe you're right. By the way, Paul arrived yesterday. He's with his military friends. Why don't you go over there and say hello? Yeah. But you know, I think the boys would prefer to be alone.
Come on, guys. Try not to smash anything up.
Relax, old man. No breakage yet.
Less of the old man. And you're quite right, yet. You keep doing what you're doing, boy. You'll be drinking your beer from the floor. Me, I prefer it in a glass. He carries one keg, and he's already desperate for a drink. Come to think of it, me too.
Now that's more like it.
Why don't we start with beers in the first place?
Because we have a wedding party to get ready. Jesus Christ. Let me get civilians next time.
Where is Floyd?
There comes the Russian groom.
Speak of the devil.
There he is. Yeah.
We have to have a drink. It's the last chance for a pint as a free man.
One other problem with this bow tie. It's not really my style.
No, certainly not.
It's okay?
No, it's fine.
Mike, get some shots.
No, okay.
It's in 1 hour we're losing this guy forever.
You're so funny. We can't get wasted this early.
Relax. We're going to make it.
Yeah?
But have
guys,
a drink.
You're not even in your suits yet.
We have our suits in the car.
Yeah?
Don't worry.
Here is to the bride and groom.
Well, thank you.
To the bride and groom.
Give us one more, Mike.
Oh, we really have to go now.
No, we still have time.
We want to show you how much we love you.
Really?
And it's not what you think.
That counts for something.
Please, do show me. Ah, forget about it.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived. And I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you.
Give me another one, Mikey.
Yes!
I love you, baby. And if it's not all right, I need you, baby. And on the lonely nights, I'll be with you, baby. Trust in me when I say, oh, pretty baby. Don't let me down, I pray, oh, pretty baby. Now that I find you, stay and let me love you, baby. Let me
enough, guys. Please, you're making my ears bleed. Come on. How you want a battle, never mind a war, I'll never know.
Easy. Paul sings the enemy into submission.
And now to freedom and to all it entails.
Give me one more, Mike.
Yeah.
You know, once you're a dad, you'll remember the times when you could have a drink with us.
And a good night's sleep.
And just don't forget, the kids come out looking like me. Just a weird coincidence.
So, what are you guys doing anyway? I mean, you're just spreading democracy or what?
Ah, forget about it. It's above your pay grade.
He means confidential.
He means fuck all.
For the time being.
Yeah, well, maybe it's better that way, eh? I mean, I'm just trying to say, you know, like, I wouldn't like to lose any of you boys.
My sentiments exactly. All right, lads, bottoms up. Yep. Time to hit the church.
We are the champions, my friends. And we'll keep on fighting till the end. Bum, bum, bada, bum. We are the champions. We are the champions. No time for losers, because we are the champions.
Will be present. I'll lead your men into the fortress.
If anything goes wrong, I'll cut your fucking head off and feed it to the hogs. Are we clear?
Yes, sir.
Are we? Right. Abigail, how nice of you to barge in.
Are you sure we can trust this traitor?
Let me worry about that. I'll take care of him. We know of his whereabouts. I'll let you know when to proceed.
Muhammad al-Assiri has surfaced in Berlin, and it's your lucky day. The Germans have given us permission. They keep their little feet under the desks until it's all over.
Beautiful.
Yes, but I'm not sure if you're the right man for the job.
If there's nothing else on your mind, I'd like to get the show on the road.
If anything goes wrong in Berlin, it's your head on a platter, not mine. I will not let you drag me into another clusterfuck of yours. And the same goes for your little sequel in the Middle East. Are we clear?
Thank you.
going to come. Don't worry. I'm not sure what he's up to, but attending a wedding party is certainly not on his schedule today.
Are up in arms.
Well, you can't blame them, it's in their nature.
Your job was to take out Mohammed al-Assiri, not five innocent bystanders.
We couldn't leave any witnesses.
This one will not explain itself away. There will be repercussions. The Foreign Office has basically camped us out my office right now.
You will find something.
You make me sick. You would probably sacrifice your own children for your cause.
If I have to.
From now on, nothing happens here without my say-so.
Of course. Anything else?
Please have your attention. I know you've all been looking at me all night long, but I have got to put the focus to this wonderful man over here right now and his lovely bride. Now, the thing that you probably don't know about this man here is that he could never really get a woman like this in a million years. But with the help of his colleagues, Derek, Josh, Leia, and now he spent the whole night standing over here talking with us when he should be over there dancing with his wife. So, in one final attempt to help you out, Sydney, could you please go up there onto the dance floor to your new husband and show him what he can look forward to for the rest of his life? Mr. DJ, could we please have the most romantic song in your playlist?
Let's waste no time. Let's get to the point. This is Omar al-Muhtari, the head of the terror organization Black Sunday. He is responsible for the massacre during the St. George parade in Stone Cross 4 years ago, killing 128 people. This is Tarek Musab al-Sakari. According to our intel, he's Mutari's second in command. And number three, Mohammed al-Asari. Since noon today, he's no longer in the picture. We have confirmation that Mutari and Sakari are hiding in Fort Latakia. Your mission is to liquidate them both. You put a team together, only our best men. My son and his unit. And my stepdaughter. You take the fort and kill every single bastard in it. Can I count on you, Phillips?
Yes, sir. I won't disappoint you, sir.
Something else. No one knows about this operation. Not the Allies, not the media, not even our Prime Minister. If we fail, all our heads will roll. Get my drift, Phillips?
Yes, sir. Understood.
Good. Back to work. Dismissed.
Sir!
All right, all right. This is the best party ever. I'm proud of you. You're going to be a great husband, a great father, and an even better soldier. Which is about time, because up until now you've been pretty shit.
You bastard!
Give me a shot for my brother.
Mike, it's all of us.
Shots on the house.
Ooh.
And here comes the other Anderson. I thought you didn't party with us.
Thanks. Give her a break. Let her be a girl for one night of the year. Hell, in these civilian clothes, even she might get lucky tonight.
Yeah, Paul, like any girl would have you without charging by the hour.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, look, I want to say something. You guys are the reason why I love the army. You always have my back.
And we always give you shit.
And hold your hair back while you puke.
You know, guys, I wouldn't make it without you.
Get your ass shot off without us.
Most likely by terrorists.
Or by you cleaning your weapon.
Oh, soldier, soldier, won't you marry me with your musket, fife, and drum? Oh, soldier, soldier, won't you marry me with your musket, fife?
You think that war is a game, son?
Sir, you think we put our lives on the line for fun?
What do you know about war, old man?
Most likely. More than you, son. Instead of playing in the desert sand, my war was closer to home. So many of my friends, good friends, died during the troubles in Northern Ireland. You know, it could hit you any time and anywhere.
Northern Ireland? Are you fucking kidding me?
Sorry, we meant no disrespect.
No, neither did I. Thank you. Good luck.
Maybe you have the point.
Someone's had a few drinks. Are you looking after him?
Looks like we get to go to base tomorrow.
Finally.
Sydney.
I'll go. Please.
It was bound to happen sooner or later.
Not now. Not on my wedding. The worst part is that he seems to be excited to leave.
He's not. He's just...
It's just what?
That is what we are trained for. You married a soldier. That means more than just a normal job. It's a lifestyle.
You sound like a recruitment poster.
It's really too hard for me. I'm just tired of what we do, never knowing what's on the other side. It's hopeless. Sydney, go to your husband. Enjoy your wedding. It's a great day. Come on, let's go. I'll join you in a second. I'm leaving the army.
Because of Dad?
No. Yes. Because of everything. I used to think that we stood for something.
We do stand for something. Whatever's going on between you and Dad, I mean...
Yeah, the great warrior, yeah.
Hey, come on, that's not fair.
He's such a pain, talking shit. I can't do this anymore.
Listen, I get it, okay? I understand. I have to stay for this next mission.
I can't do this anymore.
Hey, you're the best sniper in the team. We need you. Promise. I'll bring you back safely. And then you can do whatever you want. Later. Please.
You, this mission is top secret and will remain covert at all times. Even the smallest cock-ups cannot be allowed. All of our lives depend on it. Remember, we're not here to capture this man. We're here to eliminate him. We're not leaving this fortress until every motherfucker is killed. Are we absolutely clear?
Sir, yes, sir!
Are we clear on this, soldier?
Yes, sir, we are clear.
Today, all Muslims celebrate Eid al-Adha, the sacrificial feast. When the sun rises, all the motherfuckers will gather in a courtyard of the fortress for their prayers. It is at that moment we will attack. Are we clear?
Sir, yes, sir!
Then move your asses. There's no time for relaxing.
You all know what to do. On my go. Go.
Is over. Watch out for them, okay?
Jackson, Wilson, McDermott and O'Brien, you go first, now! Anderson, both Andersons, O'Neill and Sturgis, go!
Good now.
We only wait for 5 minutes. Clear. Okay, guys. Wait until all the motherfuckers are in the courtyard. Then we take the bastards out. On my signal.
Everyone, on positions.
Allahu Akbar.
Are you sure Al-Matari is going to show up?
If he doesn't, he will be a sinner.
Allahu Akbar.
Leah, do you have the right position?
Yes, sir. I can see the whole courtyard.
When we engage, you must cover us.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let the show begin.
Wait until I give you the signal to engage.
Thank you.
Yes. Yes. Okay.
Take them down.
Probably.
I said no talking!
Lieutenant Lea Belova Andersen. Are you Russian?
No, British.
British? So, so. Captain Andersen, I'm deeply sorry to ruin your mission. I guess it was ultra secret. But now I can't wait to see the reaction of the Russians and the Chinese. When they discover that the British are planning attacks without international approval, diplomatic consequences will be very severe. I was born into a rather large family. 5 brothers, 4 sisters. My brothers are with Allah now, having given the ultimate gift to our cause. But 2 of my sisters are dead, as are my parents, killed by a stray bomb. You think you want to fight this war? That it's necessary for democracy, yes? It is not. You are nothing. But the lapdogs of the House of Saud who want to rule all true believers. You, they already rule. British, American, French. You need them so much that you are unwilling to see what is in front of you. A corrupt regime that wants all Muslims to be its followers, its slaves, its subjects. My people only want to follow the word of the Prophet. We don't want to have yards or Rolls Royces. We don't go to Cannes to buy drink alcohol, cavort with horse. Ours is the pure Islam without the holiday of sin. Our women do not wear lingerie from Victoria's Secret under their chateaus. But for the House of Saud, you make excuses. We who are pure are the enemy. Because buying oil and gas from the House of Saud was always more convenient for you. Like you order from Amazon. The prices may vary, but in the end you know they will always sell it to you. Because their lust for money always trumps the teaching of the Prophet. Give me an answer. What would you do if I were in your position and you in mine? Would you kill me?
If you touch her, I will kill you. I wouldn't think twice.
I know that. I will free one of you to bring a message to your commander. The other one will stay here and will suffer the same punishment as your friend. You have 2 hours.
Mum took me to the Barnian Cemetery. That day I discovered Richard was not my father. And you were not really my brother. Mum didn't want you and Richard to know about it. From that day, I just pretended I didn't know who my father really is.
I know.
For me, you always were. And always will be my real brother. No matter what, I want you to know this, Paul. I don't think I'm going to survive this.
Yes, you will. And you will go home.
I won't leave you here, Paul. I couldn't live thinking I let you die while I take the exit door like a coward.
Leah, we have the chance for one of us to survive. It's not right to sacrifice two lives.
You don't owe me anything, Paul.
Decision is made.
You can't do this. We both go, or we both die.
Get your hands off me. Get off!
MC.
The person who stays can have this or this. The person who goes is free.
I'll go.
Take him away.
Oh.
Ah! He's not a hero.
Mom. So. After the news of your death, I moved out of the house. I had a kidney transplant. I started teaching again. I've got a dog. His name's Arthur. 3 years, Leah. Where were you?
What did the army tell you?
Richard told me that none of you made it out except Paul, and the entire operation was classified.
And Paul?
Paul backed him up.
Last time I saw him was at your funeral, but he couldn't look me in the eye. I thought it was guilt.
He doesn't know I'm still alive, Mom. Nobody from my old Almond Land does. And they can never know. What happened to Sydney?
Sydney. She couldn't accept Floyd's death. She lost the baby. She was very fragile.
I would like to see her.
No. You can't. She took her own life.
I have to tell you something, Mum.
You can't stay.
Not here in England. There'll be one last mission and then I'm out. I'll find a way to let you know.
So, you're still a soldier?
In a way.
Will I see you again?
Sure. I'm sorry.
How do you plan to receive the payment for rockets you never sold to us?
As we discussed earlier, we'd be open to selling the missiles to you that are currently unavailable. We would only ask that you send the money from one of your Swiss accounts.
What does that mean? It will become public.
Let's just say that I've arranged for a lapse in financial oversight.
I have the delivery times for the missiles.
Thank you.
All in position.
We are in position.
We cannot waste time anymore.
We do it as planned.
Three.
Two. One.
Exactly.
it from now.
With many deals still to be made.
Miss Ferguson will provide the banking details. But we'll make it work.
What in God's name's going on here?
The party's over.
I'm not scared of you. Who are you? What is this?
Cut them. Shoot them all if necessary. Or convenient.
Stand up! I said stand up!
Responsibility for their aggressive war against believers in the true Islam all over the world. We also demand the release of all our brothers and sisters held at so-called black sites without due process. Lastly, we also demand the withdrawal of all coalition troops from the holy land of our ancestors.
Let's make this short and quick. Our Prime Minister, weakling that he is not willing to take any risks and fulfill even one of their demands. This would surely mean disaster and only lead to further conflicts in the Middle East. Not to mention damage it could do to our standing in the international community.
According to eyewitnesses, one of the terrorists is a woman. Do you recognize her? She arrived 4 days ago under the alias of Alina Petrova with a visa from Moscow, where she's lived the last 3 years. We suspect that she is at least involved in 3 military attacks in Iraq, France, and Germany. As soon as we get to Leah and her new friends, we strike.
So what exactly are you telling me?
I don't need to explain to you how dangerous she would be to us. And we know that she visited her mother. You free the hostages, send the rest to paradise, including Leah.
You'll never get away with this. I know who you are. Captain Leah Anderson. You're a traitor to your own country.
We'll see who the traitor really is. I've heard enough of his drivel. Shut him up and get him out of my sight.
With pleasure.
And you? You want the same treatment?
No, thank you. But if I may, I'd like to ask you a question.
Go ahead.
I gather you were once in the employ of the British Army. Why you have switched sides? You don't seem particularly devout to me.
I was tired of being used by men like him, or my superiors. Men who have no moral code, and hide behind queen and country to further their own agenda. Who send soldiers out to kill, and lead them out on secret battlefields when they fail. And for whom? Corrupt princes who jail their own relatives. Lure journalists into embassies to kill and dismember them. Have bombs rain down on the poorest country of the Middle East. No amount of UN conferences can make up for that. And the worst thing is that we all know about it. Have always known. And we still sell them the weapons to do it legally. And illegally.
Oh, no, 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 no. I believe, I understand, but you really think that your demands will be made?
Quite frankly, I don't care. But what happened today will not remain a secret. That's for sure. Don't get too comfortable. I'm doing this to even the scales, playing for a team of my own choosing for once. My problem is with people like him. But there are others who have legitimate grievances with you. Excuse me now. I have some issues to attend to.
You sure? You don't want to take the lead?
No, I don't like this.
You should. He is the enemy.
What's your point?
Let's get to it. Bek Musab al-Zakari, born in Lebanon. Father a lawyer, mother a doctor. Quite progressive for a terrorist.
Did I give you permission to spit? Well, did I? It's English soil you spit on.
Back home, you can spit into the desert sand all you want. Hell, isn't that all you people do anyway? The only bodily fluids hitting the ground here will be your blood, sweat, and tears. I ask you, where are they?
Yes, sir. Understood.
Let me ask you again, one more time. Where are they? That?
2 miles south of the river. There's a factory. A small country road. And just follow it to the end.
Thank you. And now?
I thought you were going to execute me.
So did I.
So why didn't you?
I saw a kindred spirit in you. Someone who was willing to die for a cause. You were just wrong about what that was.
And you're not angry that this will be my last mission?
No, for the same reason. Ours is not your cause anymore. I've seen it vanish before my eyes, especially the last few months.
But I still believe in what you do. That it's just.
That's not enough to kill people for. Since your return from Moscow, I've noticed something else. I think you found something else to fight for. Or someone, perhaps?
It's that obvious?
No. Not to everyone. But I've got to know you very well, Leah Anderson. But remember, they will always be after you. They will always try to hunt you down. You can only stop running once you're dead.
Arthur?
Do you want to kill me a second time?
Leia. Please.
Get the job done.
Stay here. You can play with yourself while I do the job. Wim. Привет.
Nikolai! Nikolai!
This thing happening to you.